Yes, students, the right side, yes, it's possible. You can just try this, okay, and you will get the same matrix. I just wanted to check this answer once, everyone, once we do that, because even I don't know what is the answer, so I've just done it, okay. If you still want me to solve, I can solve it, okay. I know it's better if I only solve it. So, matrix A is given by 1, 1, minus 1, the next 2, 0, 3. And the next 3 minus 1, 2, and that is multiplied by B. So 1, 3, 0, 2, minus 1, 4. So let's multiply these two. So what is the multiplication of these two will give me? So first row, first column. So 1 multiplied by 1, 1. The next one is 0, and the next one is plus 1. So let us start with second row. Sorry, first row, second column. So 1 multiplied by 3, 3 plus 2 minus 4. Right. Now let us start with second row. So second row, first column. So 2 plus 0 minus 3. The next second row, second column. 6 plus 0 plus 12. Right. The next one, let's start with third row. 3 multiplied by 1. 3 plus 0 minus 2. Third row, second column. So it should be 9 minus 2 plus 8. So upon multiplying, what is the elements I'm going to get here? So it's going to be 2, here it's going to be 1, and the next one is going to be minus 1. So here it is 18, and this one is 1. So here it's going to be how much? So it's going to be 7 plus 5, 15. This is AB. This should be multiplied with C, no? So let us consider AB multiplied with C. So what is AB? We got 2, 1, minus 1, 18, 1, 15. This is multiplied by C. What is matrix C is given to us? I know you're getting bored of this. Too much of a lengthier problem. But what to do? We both don't have an option. For 5 marks, we should learn it. Okay, now let us go for multiplication. So it's going to be what? First row. First column. So 2 multiplied by 1, 2 plus 2 multiplied by 1 multiplied by 2 will be 2. Now let us start with the next. First row, second column. So 2 multiplied by 2, 4 plus 1 multiplied by 0, 0. Now the next one. 2 multiplied by 3, 6. 1 multiplied by minus 2 will be minus 2. 2 multiplied by minus 4 is minus 8. 1 multiplied by 1, that's going to be 1. Finished? Now the next. Second row, first column. So minus 1 multiplied by 1, 1. Minus 1 plus, it's going to be 36. Correct. Now the next. Minus 1 multiplied by 2, minus 2. And 18 multiplied by 0, that's going to be 0. Next. Minus 3 and minus 36, that's fine. Now the next one. Minus into, that's going to be plus 4, plus 18. Let us start with the last row, first column. That is last row, first column. 1 multiplied by 1, 1 plus 15 multiplied by 2. So that's going to be how much? 30. That's okay. Now the next. 1 multiplied by 2, 2 plus 0. Now the next one. 3 minus 30. Okay. Now the next. Minus 4 plus 15. That's okay. Just look at that. Upon simplifying, I'm going to get the same matrix what I've already done it for the left side. So finally, I can come to a conclusion. A multiplied by BC is equal to AB multiplied by C. It's a standard property. Matrix multiplication is always associated. Okay, so no need to prove, it's known fact actually. Matrix multiplication is always going to be associative. So this problem definitely for 5 marks. Okay, so as I said, there are hardly 4 to 5 problems for 4 to 5 problems of 5 marks in this chapter, and it is purely based on matrix multiplication only. So this is one such kind of problem. An easy chapter to score mark, that's it. Okay, so we finished with the fifth one. So let's continue. Even the next one is also an important one. So there are three matrix, matrix A, B, C are given to you. What is that they're asking? Calculate AC, BC, A plus B multiplied by C. Also verify that A plus B multiplied by C will be equal to AC plus BC for 5 marks in the final examination. Okay. Now, so let us start these two things first. Let's find out AC. So matrix A is given by 0, 6, 7, minus 6, 0, 8, 7, minus 8, 0. And matrix C, 2, minus 2, 3. I suggest you to note down the order first and then continue. Order of the first matrix, 3 by 3. Order of this matrix, 3 by 1. 3 rows, 1 column, correct? No? These two are same. So matrix multiplication is possible. The order of the resultant matrix is going to be 3 by 1. That means 3 rows, 1 column. Okay. This will reduce the error actually. Okay. Most of the students will go wrong. Okay. After multiplying, what's the order? If you know this fact in the earlier stage, it's easy to go and complete the problem. So let's continue. First row, only 1 column. Okay. 1 column, 1 row. So 0 multiplied by 2, 0. 6 multiplied by minus 2, minus 12. 7 multiplied by 3, 21. That's it, because there is no other column to continue with first row. The next. Second row, first column. So minus 6 multiplied by 2, minus 12, plus 0, plus 24. Next. 7 multiplied by 2, 14. Next. It's going to be 16. And 0 plus 3 is going to be 0. That's fine. Okay. Now what do you got, AC? So it's going to be how much? So this is going to be 8, 8 plus 1, 9. So here it's going to be 12. The last is going to be 20, and that's going to be 30. This is matrix AC. Similarly, I should find out that my next element is going to be BC. So let's have this in mind. So let us find out B multiplied by C. So let me just check what is B is given. So B is given as 0, 1, 1, 1, 0, 2, 1, 2, 0, multiplied by C, 2, minus 2, 3. So let us simplify these two now. So let's go for matrix multiplication. Okay, so first row, first column, again the order is going to be still the same, 3 cross 1 only, you can just check that. Okay, so 0 multiplied by 2, 0, and the next 1 multiplied by minus 2, minus 2, 1 multiplied by 3, 3. With first row we finished. Now let's continue with second row. So 1 multiplied by 2, 2 plus 0, and this is going to be 6. Now next. Third row, first column. So 1 multiplied by 2, 2 minus 4, 2 multiplied by minus 2, right? And the next one is going to be 0. So what you get here is 1, 8, and this is going to be 4, right? So this is AC and BC. Let's remember these two, we need it. And what else I should find? I should find something called as A plus B multiplied by C. Okay. Now let me have these two matrix somewhere here. I need it later on. So this is BC and this is 9, 12, 30. So this is my matrix AC. I need it later. So solve it. So the next matrix what I want is, I want something called as A plus B multiplied by C. That means add A and B, that should be multiplied with C. So first let us find out A plus B. So it is there, so I will do it directly. We know the concept of addition. So this is going to be 0, then 7, then 8. This is A plus B I am doing. So minus 5. So it's going to be 0 and 10. The next one is going to be 8. That's minus 6 and 0. This is A plus B what I have done. Okay. Now let's continue with C. What is C is given as? 2, minus 2, 3. A plus B I have done. And that should be multiplied with C. That is the meaning. So, as usual, let's put the arrows. Okay. So, 0 multiplied by 2. 0. 7 multiplied by minus 4. Minus 14. 8 multiplied by 3. 24. Fine. Now, second row, first column. So, this is going to be minus 10 plus 0 plus 30. Now, the next is going to be 16 plus 12 plus 0. So, let us simplify this. What do you get here? Is going to be 10, so this is going to be 20, and this is going to be 28. I hope that's fine. The last row, let's just want to check. So it's going to be 16 plus 12 plus 8. Yeah, this is the matrix A plus B multiplied by C. What is the condition I need to check? I need to check that A plus B multiplied by C should be equal to AC plus BC. I have AC and BC here. Okay. I just want to check somewhere I've gone wrong, because this is only 1 second. So it's going to be how much? This is 20 and this is going to be 10. the last one, 30 plus 4, 34 I should get here. Have I wrong gone wrong somewhere? So a plus b is okay. I just want to check a plus b once now. So it's going to be the last one I want to check. So 7 plus 1, 8. That's fine. So minus 8 plus 2, that's going to be 6. That's fine. And 2 to 3. Yeah, that's okay. There's nothing wrong. So it's going to be 8 to the 16. And that's going to be minus 6 minus 12. Correct? No. So that's plus 12. So this is going to be 20, 28 only. Then somewhere. I think here only I have one wrong somewhere. That's okay. You can manage. Okay, it has to be equal, which verify actually. It has to come equal. So this element I have gone wrong somewhere, because here I am getting 28. Okay. But if I add up these two, if you want to notice, just add up these two matrix which are given. So it's going to be 10. So this is going to be 20, which are same like this. So this should be 34 I am getting, and 25. I just want to check these two once again. So please verify, you will get the answer. Okay. Maybe I went wrong somewhere, so I am just checking it, so I am unable to find it. That's okay, you can just check this. 4, 4. It's okay students, you can verify this. Okay. Since everything, if it's there on the board, I can just go and just check where I went wrong exactly, but I erased most of the things. So for me it's going to be difficult to just go and check once again. So it's okay, no problem, you can verify. I know you people are more accurate than me. Okay, please do it. Okay, now the seventh one, again an important. So for 5 marks I've already discussed 2 problems. Now this one, the next one is also going to be for 5 marks. If matrix A is given as 1 2 3 3 minus 2 1 4 2 1, then prove that A cube minus 23A minus 40i should be equal to 0. It's a prove that, so we need to prove it. Clear? So some students have noticed actually, if matrix A is given, you want A cube. Some students have, even in the final examination also, in the evaluation we have seen this. If matrix A is given, how to find A cube? Quite simple sir, you just cube every element from this and you will get A cube. Don't laugh, okay. Most of the students will do this. Even after my instruction also, some of the students will do it. That is not an issue. Come back. How to find A cube? A cube I cannot go and find directly. Okay, first thing, A square. A multiplied by, I'm going to start from this. I want A cube. A cube is written as A square multiplied by A. So first find A square, that multiplied by A, that is going to give me A cube. That is how the procedure. So how to multiply it by, how to multiply A multiplied by A. So 1. 2, 3, 3 minus 2, 1, 4, 2, 1, multiplied by 1, 2, 3, 3 minus 2, 1, 4, 2, 1. That's okay. Now multiply these two. So, as you notice, I suggest you to put the arrows and continue. Okay. So, 1 multiplied by 1, 1. 2 multiplied by 3, 6. 3 multiplied by 4, that's going to be 12. First element. First row, second column, 1 multiplied by 2, 2, 2 multiplied by minus 4, sorry, minus 4, next, 3 multiplied by 2, 6, first row, third column, 1 multiplied by 3, 3, 2 multiplied by 1, 2, 3 multiplied by 1, 3, finished multiplication with respect to first row. Let's continue with second row, first column, 3 multiplied by 1, 3, next, minus 6, then, plus 4, let me keep writing. I know you people can manage this. So 6 minus 4 plus 2. The next, 9 minus 2 plus 1. The next one, 4 plus 6 plus 4. Next, 8 minus 4 plus 2. And the last one is going to be 12 plus 2 plus 1. I hope you can manage. Okay. So we got A square. So finally, what is A square? A square is a matrix. So how much this is going to be? 18 plus 1, that's going to be 19. The next one is going to be how much? This is minus 2 plus 6. Minus 2 plus 6, it's going to be 4. Correct, right? Okay. Now the next one is going to be 8. Surely I mean my calculator, because numbers are bigger, it's going to be. So it's going to be 1 and this is going to be 4, and this one is going to be 8. Now the next one, so it's going to be 14, the next one is 6, and here it's going to be 15. This is a square, that's all. Okay, now let us go and find out a cube. So how to write a cube? A cube is written as a square multiplied by a. So what is a square? 19, 4, 8, 1, 4, 8, 14, 6, 15. Multiplied by a, 1, 2, 3, 3 minus 2, 1, 4, 2, 1. Now the procedure of matrix multiplication starts here. So 19 multiplied by 1, 19 plus 12 plus 32, right? Then the next one, so it's going to be 38 minus 8 plus 16, the last one. So it's going to be 63, let's find that, 67, plus 4 plus 8, fine. So let's continue the second row, so it's going to be 1 plus 12 plus 32, okay, the next one. 1 multiplied by 2, so it is 2 minus 8 plus 16, that's okay. Now the next one, so 1 multiplied by 3, 3 plus 4 plus 8. With the last row, 14 plus 6, 3 is 18 plus 60. Now the next one, 14 multiplied by 2, 28 minus 12 plus 30. Next one, 14 multiplied by 3, so it's going to be 28, 32, 42, 6 multiplied by 1, so plus 6 plus 15. Okay, we have multiplied. Let us simplify and let us get these elements now. My board is too small, so I should keep erasing the things. Okay, so it's going to be how much? So this will be 19 plus 2, 21, 31. Okay, 31 plus 32, 31 plus 32, 63. And here how much it's going to be? 8, 38 plus 8, 46, fine. And 79, right, the next. So this is going to be 44, 45, next one, 18 minus 8, 18 minus 8 is going to be 8, 10. So this is going to be 12 plus 3, 8, 15, so 60. 78, 78, 82, 92. This element will be 92. And this is going to be 16 plus 30, 46. And here it's going to be, so it's going to be 48, 53 and 63. This is AQ. Dear students, now what to do next, sir? Okay, so what else we want? We want a condition AQ minus 23A minus 48. So let us start up with this. A cube we already got here, okay, so this is going to be 63, 46, 79, 45, then it's going to be 10, 15, so it's 92, 46, 63, minus 23A, that means each element of matrix A is multiplied by 23, clear, right? So what is matrix A? We have each element should be multiplied by 23, so 23, so 23 is going to be 46, so it's going to be 69. Fine, students? Right. Let's go to the next. And the next one. The next one is what? So it's going to be 69. Okay. So 69 minus 46, 23. And the next one is 92 it's going to be. So it's 23 multiplied by 4. Okay. Now the next one is 23 multiplied by 2. 46, and this will be 23 minus 40i. We have something called as 40i. What does I stands for? Identity matrix of order 3 cross 3. Correct? No. What is identity matrix? 1, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 0, 0, 1. This is identity matrix. 40i means multiply each element. Are quite simple. The diagonal elements will be replaced by 43. So this will be 43, 0, 0, 0, 43, 0, 0, 0, 43. Finally, it is a show the column, and this answer has to be equal to 0 at any cost. So if not, maybe I would have done something wrong. You can just check if you want. Okay, here only if you want to check, I know this should be, this is minus 69 and this should be minus 79. This should be minus 69 only. AQ. I went wrong. I know that. I know there are some places where even I can go wrong. So you can notice here 63. Minus 23, minus 43. Don't write 0 in one step directly. Okay. So what I suggest you, you write down like this. Okay. So first element is 63. Next, minus 23. And here, minus 43. Like this you write down. Okay. Don't show it as 0 directly. No. You show simplification. Next one. So here it's 46. There's a minus sign. So 46. And here it is 0. So it's okay. No problem. You can write that. And here it is 69 minus 69. And the last element is 0 again. So it's okay. Leave that. Okay. And notice here. I know there's some place even I went wrong. I know that. So I want to just check when you're doing the simplification part here. So certainly I would have went wrong here. So this should be 69. Okay. Even there also I've done wrong while doing calculation. So please verify. Okay. So here it's going to be 69 minus 69. So how much here is present here? Definitely in a cube. Students, I want you to just check a square and a cube once again. Just check these two. Okay, right. Now let's continue. So it's going to be, see, have 10 here. So sir, I can just notice myself. I've done something wrong easily. So it's what I'm going to get here. 10 minus into minus will be plus 46. And here how much I'm getting? Minus 43. Certainly it's not getting 0, but I should get 0 actually. So somewhere I went wrong, so please verify. Anyway, the next element, 15 minus 23 also. So please just check. Okay, and let's continue. So this has to be zeros. Okay, I know I am writing this. I just wanted to just check and continue. Clear? Okay. Because too many numbers, board space is very small, so there are chances. Okay, just wait for some time. I might give you the correct one also. So problem number 7, I will just give you what is exactly a square and a cube. Okay, and let's come to problem number 8. It's a statement problem. Okay, so in a legislative assembly, it's based on assembly. So matrix A. Matrix A is the cost per contact. Okay, and matrix B. Matrix B is what? Matrix B, number of contacts actually. How many calls are being made? Fine. Okay. So, what is it they're asking? Find the total cost spent by, that is what I said yesterday. Matrix is not about maths. Matrix is actually exist in our day-to-day life also. We don't know. Okay, so one such kind of problem is, so when matrix A, telephone, house call, letter. How many ways I can contact a person? And the matrix, and the matrix B is given as what? Matrix B is given as, there are two types of cities. Okay, what are the cities? Okay, X and Y. Okay, what is it they want finally? Find the total amount spent by the group in the two cities. When I want this, okay, what I need exactly is matrix B multiplied by matrix A. Okay, matrix B multiplied by matrix A. Its numbers are too lengthy, so I will not multiply. So in the eighth one, you just need to find out BA. That's it. Okay,